Welcome back. We are still here on Urban Television talking about marriage and family. And with us is Pastor Nicholas Wafula. He's also called the man of faith. Pastor, that is one thing I did not ask you about. Why man of faith?
Because I have Jesus in me.
Uh-huh.
As an individual, I live by faith with my wife. I live by faith with my children, I live by faith. With the grandchildren, I live by faith in everything that I do, my work. Yeah, I put faith first. Yeah, and I believe God, who has created the situation for me to be able to do the work. That's faith, trusting Him that He will be able to do the work, or He will be able to guide me, or He will give me the strength. He will give me the capability and ability to perform whatever errands He would have given me.
Oh, well, thank you for that, for answering to my curiosity, because I wanted to know why man of faith. Anyway, let's just go back to the conversation as we're having it earlier. We were talking about love, marriage, family. And when I asked you about why some marriages are not taking, because we expect when people get married, they should be able to walk this journey. When you get married in church, it's until death do you what?
Part.
Yeah. Yes. So you expect it will happen when that happens. But that is not happening because, as you said, most people are getting into this institution because of materialism. Yeah. So is there any advice you could give? How do we walk away from the love of material things and focus on this agape love, like you were telling us, so that we can see marriages, family flourishing in many of us?
Now, let me just be quick to say that I don't want to be misunderstood. Materials are not bad. Money is not
a bad thing.
Bad thing. Yes. But Paul, writing to Timothy, tells Timothy, the love of money is the root of all evil. Now, I want to say that materials or material is not bad, but many of us, instead of using money, using materials as our servants, we are ending up looking at them as our masters. They are controlling us. We are controlled by money. And out of the love of money, all the evil things come out. And some of the evil things that come out is divorce. Materials are not bad. A good house is not bad. A car is not bad. A good seat in the sitting room, a good bed is not bad. But if this would divert your heart away from God and divert your heart away from your spouse, then there is something wrong somewhere. So we need to guard against this loving materials other than loving the people God has given us to live with as a husband and a wife.
So how do we guard? What are those things we could do just to guard ourselves from?
With me as a preacher, as a pastor, just come to Christ and Christ will help you. And we as pastors are here to give you a few tips here and there, okay, how to do it. Yeah.
Wouldn't you give us one or two, at least for those who might say, I don't want to go to the pastor.
No.
Out of fear.
You can't fear the pastor. If the pastor is feared, then the pastor is not worth being a pastor.
Really?
Pastors are supposed to be shepherds.
Mm-hmm.
Pastors are supposed to be fathers, and they should be able to embrace everybody. The young, the old should be embraced by the pastor. If you're a pastor and you're being feared, then there's a problem there.
And if I may ask, how did you guard against material things overtaking?
I think it's because where I came from. My background, I told you, my background, the self-contained house, we didn't have much. So we learned to have the little, whatever God gave us. Up to today, we are still in the school learning that whatever God has given us is what we use. We don't want to desire to have a helicopter when we cannot afford what? The helicopter.
Wow. So, Pastor, out of curiosity, have you instilled these values? Maybe I didn't ask you if you have children. Maybe you should first tell me.
Yes. We got married on the 28th of April, 1973. Mm-hmm. And our firstborn son arrived on the 2nd of May, a year later, 74. Mm. Okay, so we got married 73. Our firstborn came 74. I just want to emphasize that, just in the case somebody is counting how many months it passed before we got our firstborn. And as I said, we were the second couple in the church. So we had very strict boundaries, not to play about. You know, like what you hear these days in the churches, people are just becoming pregnant and so on. That was unheard of during our time. Mm. If you're a Christian, you're a Christian. Mm-hmm. There was no playing about with the girls, no playing about with boys. Mm.
What were the standards?
The standards that you don't play the game with your spouse.
It has to be official.
It has to be after the priest has said, let those whom God has put together, no man put asunder. If darkness came at that time, you just go ahead, no problem. You know, we were very, very strict. Mm. Holiness is one of the teaching we have in Deliverance Church. Mm. Okay? Mm. Holiness is one of those things we teach in the Deliverance Church. Mm. Yeah.
So, you said yes, firstborn.
That's what firstborn.
Yes.
And now we have five boys.
Yes.
Peter, Paul, Philip, okay? Mm-hmm. Patrick, and Patrobas. Mm. Now, we wanted a girl. So, we adopted a girl who has become part of our family. Mm. She's called Rosalind.
Oh, okay.
And no, actually, she's older than all the others, okay? She's older than the others. That's where she brought up the others. Okay. They respect her as the elder sister. And out of them, six of them now, we have 16 grandchildren. I hope we shall get more. I'm not sure. But you can't determine it now. But,
Okay, interesting. So those are six children.
Six. Then out of the six, we have 16
grandchildren. Yeah, so I'll just go back to how you talked about your humble, background. Made you learn to guard against material things. You say material things are not bad, but certain ways are not good when it comes to material things. So because of the little you had, you learned how to guard. I'm wondering if these values have been instilled on these people, and that is why they've turned out the way they are today, that you even have 16 grandchildren who perhaps will also carry these same values. Have these values gone from generation to generation? And is it working for you?
I think, and to some degree, I would say yes. One, I have not had any of them being arrested for stealing. Okay? So I believe that the values have been followed. And I have not seen any of them in Zachariant living. Okay? I have watched them, and they are living very simple and humble lives. God has blessed, okay, the firstborn is working with the KCCA, the second one is working with the Standard Chartered Bank, but he's based in Dubai, The third one is a lawyer, and the fourth one is an electrician, and the fifth one is a lawyer. Yes, we have two lawyers. The youngest is actually a lawyer, and he graduated last year in Illinois University with a Master's of Laws. But before that, he worked in Uganda as a commissioner for equal opportunity. He was one of the commissioners of the Equal Opportunity Commission for 10 years before he went out to study further. And our daughter took mama's trade, being a nurse, a midwife. Now she is into counseling. She got a master's in counseling psychology. So and none of them have lived really outrageous lives. So I think they have learned a little bit. And that was our emphasis for them. Whenever they went to school, we want to tell them, even the grandchildren. Yesterday, I got a grandchild here. They passed through here, taking him to senior one. I said, behave well. Avoid bad company.
Okay, interesting. So, Pastor, I'm just curious. Do you have maybe some, can I call it a quote, that guides you when it comes to family, marriage, and love, that maybe some people can also look at?
You said what?
A quote or a mantra or something when it comes to love, marriage, family.
Yeah. I don't think I have a special quote there. But as I said, in whatever situation, I have hung on that statement that I gave you, my walking stick. He who calls you is faithful, and he will do it. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 24. So it is my God who has helped me, and I would say it is true to anybody who trusts himself or herself to the Lord.
Well, how I love hymns. So I don't know if you have a song, a hymn that also guides you in this journey. What is your favorite hymn?
You wait. You come on the celebration.
Oh, 50 but years.
But I like our song that we like in such terms is God is faithfulness. God is faithfulness.
Do you want to sing for us?
I'm not a singer, so I can't sing for you.
Could,
I don't want to spoil people's contaminate people's songs. But that is one of our
favorite.
It is even part of it is in our sitting room.
Okay.
God is faithfulness. God is a faithful God. And we depend on him, and he has kept us going all through life.
How do you plan to celebrate this golden jubilee in marriage? 50 years. What do you have in plan?
First and foremost, it's a Thanksgiving day, basically. It's a Thanksgiving day, and because of our stature, being founders of Deliverance Church, that's what we are going to emphasize. I wish we had the cows and the goats with slaughter for everybody, but we don't have that. So, and we wanted as open a place as possible. That's why we asked that we celebrate it at the National Independence Ground, where there's enough room for everybody. And it will be basically a Thanksgiving service. And my general overseer of Deliverance Church, plus the overseer emeritus, the one I handed over the ministry to, those will be leading the service. And the other, the preacher, is Bishop J.B. Masinde from Nairobi. He's one of those who were present when we got married. Mm. Among us, the few Kenyans who came, I think could have been less than 5 people, that he was present. But now, a leader of one of our churches in Kenya, so he will be coming. Bishop J.B. Masinde will be the preacher. Yes, so it will be basically a Thanksgiving service.
When you said those independence grounds, do you mean Kololo?
Yes.
Oh, so is everybody invited?
No.
If I wanted to come?
No.
And just
no, you cannot just walk in. At the moment...
Well, what happened to the African spirit
that's the problem now. Because we are balancing ourselves between technology and physical. So we are going to put it on Zoom, so that those who are in the, we have friends in the UK, in America, Germany, China, all over the globe, we have friends. They will watch us online. And even here, we would have loved to have everybody, but we can't. So those who are coming to join with us must make sure they have been invited and they have a card. There will be restrictions on entry point.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Yours is an amazing journey, especially when we're talking, celebrating a golden jubilee in marriage, or 50 years in marriage. Not many people have that. So what advice would you give young people to walk this same journey that you've walked, so that they too, at one point in their life, will celebrate 50 years, a golden jubilee, in marriage, or even a century, 100 years, who knows, it could happen. So what advice would you give the youth?
With me as a Christian, I would just say stick to Jesus and stick to one another. Mm. As I have already said, I'll be repeating myself. Mm. Stick to Jesus and stick to one another. Mm. And actually 50 years will go very quickly.
Right.
I don't believe it. The other day we were celebrating 25. Now, it looked like it was a long journey away. 50 has just come.
Mm.
Because if you're enjoying something, time passes very fast.
Mm.
Yeah. And I think we have enjoyed our marriage life and our parental life.
Mm.
So life is passing quite easily and very quickly.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay. And for the men, because now you lived, you served your purpose, you opened a church, you got family, everything has worked out, and you even handed over the church to somebody else, although you still preach, as you told me earlier. I believe you're living the good life of, you know, having met your purpose, and now you're in retirement and enjoying it fully. I hope I'm right, that it's fulfilling. So what advice would you give other men out there to walk the same journey like you have done, and also enjoy their retirement when the time comes?
Actually, I would say what the Bible says. I think the Bible says that David served the Lord during his generation. So that should be our purpose, whether you are young or old. Serve your God during your generation. And when you are serving the Lord, I don't think there is a retirement. Okay, a retirement is a word we use. I prefer handing over.
Okay.
Like I told you, I didn't say I retired, I handed over to somebody else.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what I'm doing, when I started as a DAI, Minister Center Director for Uganda, later on I handed it to somebody else. I'm now a regional director for East and South Africa. So the picture you get is that, like the tires, I have a friend of mine, he says you don't retire, you mean you put on new tires to run differently. Okay? So in the call of God, it simply means at different times, God will use you to do different things. I remember a statement made by the late Bishop Mukasa of Mitiana. He told me one time, he said, Nick, I'm not a retired bishop. I'm just a tired bishop. the things I used to do, I no longer do it at the same pace.
Right.
So I don't look at Christianity or the Christian leader as a retired person. I look at it, you are just tired. You do maybe the same things or different things, but at a slower pace.
With different energy.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Pastor.
Actually, I have a song which I normally sing. Uh-huh. The things I used to do, I don't do them anymore. During that time, I used to preach 3 times a day, 4 times a day, and right. I would be still ticking.
Right.
This day, I preach 2 times, and I'm finished.
Well, we hope it keeps at 2 and it doesn't go down anymore.
Well, even if it is 2 minutes, that would be good enough for me.
All right. Thank you so much, Pastor, for your time. It has been a nice conversation, and I know many people are watching and picking lessons out of how you've lived your life when it comes to love, marriage, and family. And congratulations on your 50 years of marriage. It's not easy.
Thank you.
But congratulations, and thank you for having taken time to speak to us. Well, that has been Pastor Nicholas Wafula, one of the renowned churchmen in Uganda and East Africa. We have been talking about love, marriage, family, and from what I gathered from this conversation, he said we should not focus so much on material things. They are good, yes, but let's focus on agape love, because with that you are able to love somebody unconditionally, and your marriage, your family, your love will flourish. Until next time, I have been your host, Jackie Chan. Goodbye.